What's going on, everyone? Venomsting 234 here, and I'm back with a bit of a put my few pennies on the table for a video called. It was made by Run Hard Get Paid, and he was basically giving the dark side of trucking. A lot of people have been bashing on him because of what he did. With experience with that, I think he was just showing what truckers go through sometimes, on some occasions, is that the dispatch, with from what I've been through, is that they have no experience truck driving. They just been put on there as a desk job, and it can piss a lot of us drivers off, which I'm saying us drivers, I mean, I'm going back pretty soon. So he's just showing that some dispatchers, what weapons they can use to push us to do some things that are extremely dangerous, that can cost us our CDL, some money through tickets, and God forbid, as going to prison in a manslaughter case. As for me, when I was with the two companies I was with, I always said, you know what, if I'm starting to doze off, I'm shutting down. No ifs, ands, or buts. You can find someone to pick up this load, and I can deliver his load or the empty trailer that he's bringing. I don't care if I'm doing something dangerous, and if I'm starting to... do that. The minute I notice I'm doing that, I'm finding the nearest truck stop or rest area, and I'm shutting down. Now, some people don't know the symptoms of... excuse me. of noticing it. Pardon me. Is the biggest thing I notice when, for me, is when I'm driving at night or day, or it doesn't matter, is I'm starting to... as my head goes back, one eye squints really hard, one the other eye is just wide open, and I'm just fighting. And he's just showing that, I mean, Run Hard, Get Paid is just showing what dispatchers do. Some of them. I mean, not all of them are like that, but some of them are, and they'll just use anything they can to force you to go back on the road. It just blew me away, and just to get you back on the road. I mean, the only thing they really care about is getting that load to the destination on time. It just blew me away how they were speaking to him. My dispatcher that I had was like, okay, we'll talk it over with the customer. We'll have you pulled off the road. We'll try to find someone to get this off you. And so on and so forth. It was pretty clear that the company he was with, and I'm not going to disclose them, is that the night dispatcher and the night dispatcher, the dispatcher's manager, just didn't give a crap about his safety. They didn't give a shit. And if I was in his situation, I would have said, okay, will you be willing to pay for my lawyer fees, court date fees, all that kind of stuff off of me? Can you pay for it for me? And if they would have said no, then, well, I'm sorry, but my freedom and my safety are number one. And if they did anything to threaten me, like take away my paycheck for the week, I'd say, okay, I'll see you in court. And I would turn my truck in, and I would just quit. It's not worth it. And also, the way he was also acting was, it didn't seem like over-the-road trucking was for him. He's now doing, like, local stuff, which it seems like it does better for him, and good for him. And run hard, get paid. I wish you all the best of luck with whatever you're doing. I mean, just that's what I want to put out there. Anyway, that's all I have to say about that. Don't forget to like, subscribe, favorite, share this. Also, go subscribe to Run Hard, Get Paid so you can see this video for yourself. It's somewhere on his YouTube page. And I actually enjoyed it. It does show what us drivers sometimes go through. Oh, and if you didn't notice this, Bluetooth paired headset. And it's, I love this thing, and you'll be seeing me wear this a lot more often in my videos. So, again, like, subscribe, favorite, share, and I'll see you guys later.